garden, and it's beautiful day. It's your botanical garden. Can't wait till we can all enjoy it here again. We're going to do a little yoga class. So if you want to find some space, roll out your mat, get nice and comfy, maybe grab some water. I always like to grab a little essential oils, kind of get me in the mood, get me nice and relaxed. And then when you're ready, lie down on your back, taking a nice comfortable position, stretching the legs out, or maybe even bringing the soles of the feet together and letting the knees open. Maybe opening palms up or laying the palms down, or perhaps taking the left hand to the heart and the right hand to the belly. Arriving here, staying on your back, and begin to take notice of your breath. Notice how the breath feels in your body, and notice how your body feels as you breathe. Just breathing normally and naturally right now, allowing the breath to enter the body through the nose, circulating through the body, and either exiting through the nose or perhaps parting the lips, and gently allowing the breath to come out through the mouth. Noticing the fullness in your body as you inhale, and the emptying as you exhale. The expansion of each inhalation, and the contraction with each exhalation. Taking a moment just to breathe, allowing your body to tell you how much oxygen you need, and remembering to fully exhale. Taking a moment to scan the body, taking that inhalation all the way from your toes, up your ankles, shins, knees, quads, hips, into that solar plexus, allowing the breath to move through the chest, through the throat, feeling it in your fingers, in your wrists, your elbows, relaxing through your shoulders. And as you exhale, exhaling all the way back down. Starting at the crown, moving down the face, and as you exhale, scanning the body, releasing any tension with that exhalation. Taking another full inhalation through the nose, scanning the body for tension as you inhale, and as you exhale, finding that special little spot, exhaling into that spot of tension and releasing. Taking one more round of breath, just like this. Inhale. And exhale. On your next inhalation, I invite you to begin to scan the mind without judgment. We all have thoughts. We all make our lists. But just for this next time while we practice, I invite you to let those go. So take a moment, take a nice full inhalation, scanning the mind, and as you exhale, exhale those thoughts. Save them for later, they'll be there. They'll come back when you leave your mat. So taking three nice full rounds of breath, inhaling, exhaling those thoughts that don't serve you right now. Why do we practice yoga? Why do we meditate? We practice yoga to bring us all together, to yogas. The word yoga actually means yoga. So we practice asana in order for us to come to a place where we can sit and meditate. Where we can be alone with our thoughts. Where we can realize ourself. And once we realize the importance of our own self, then we can give more of ourselves to others. them, knowing that compassion for yourself and self-love is the most important step in being able to establish, to create and establish relationships with others. I invite you, there on your back, to create an intention for your practice, a word or phrase that you can come back to, perhaps compassion, perhaps self-love. Taking a nice full inhalation and inhaling that intention into your body. And then exhaling anything that doesn't serve you for this time of your practice. And I'm actually going to start some music for me. You're welcome to turn on any music that you like if you don't already have any home. Or you can just allow my voice to guide you in practice. There on your back, I invite you to stretch your legs out if they're not already and begin to wiggle the toes, maybe wiggle the fingers, bringing movement and awareness back into your body. Pointing and flexing the feet, rolling the wrists and ankles. When you're ready, bringing the knees into your chest and giving yourself a nice hug, maybe rocking left to right, maybe rocking forward and back, massaging the spine, awakening the body. Then finding stillness here, bringing the arms out to a T, palms facing up, taking an inhalation using your core to bring those knees into your chest, and as you exhale, take those knees over to the left side, your gaze to the right, taking a nice full inhalation here, being kind to your body. One more nice full round of your breath. And inhaling those knees back up to center. Exhale, bring those knees to the right, the gaze to the left. Taking three full rounds of your breath here. Breathing into that nice twist, knowing how good this is for your intestines, for your digestion. Also to release tension, helping to bring focus. Inhale those knees back to center, wrapping those arms around the knees, giving yourself a nice big hug once again. And then beginning to take those rolls front to back until you find yourself in a comfortable seated position. About in the middle of the mat or so, getting nice and settled in here. Moving anything away from the bottom that keeps you from getting nice and grounded. Growing the spine tall, really inhale, and imagine that each inhalation you're adding another half an inch to your body. Releasing the tension in your face, unfurling the brow, releasing the tension in the cheeks, removing the tongue from the roof of your mouth. Taking a nice full inhalation here, and bringing the shoulders all the way up to your ears, and then exhale down and back. Extending arms to the side, the palms facing up. Inhale, arms overhead. Leaving the right palm lifted, flip the left palm. Left palm comes to the earth. Inhale, extend. Exhale, side stretch. Maybe coming to the forearm and the elbow, or maybe staying lifted, depending on where you are right now. Inhale, cartwheel the hands up. Flip the right palm. Exhale, right palm down. Inhale, extend the left side body. Exhale, side stretch. Inhale, arms overhead, palms forward this time. Exhale and walk the palms out. Taking a nice full round of breath here. Maybe tenting the fingers to make this active. Inhaling and walking the palms back to the body. Releasing the palms to the knees. Taking a note as to which foot's on top or in front, switching those for a minute, opening up our hips evenly. From here, taking the palms to the front of the knees, we're going to inhale, roll the shoulders back, opening the front body, shining the heart and the collarbones toward the sky, and exhale, roll it back in. Two more rounds of this seated cat-cow. Inhale to open. Exhale, roll it in. One more inhale, really pressing the palms into the knees.
And exhale, puffing up through the spine.
Inhale back to a nice neutral spine. Taking those fingers and walking those hands back out on your exhalation. Bringing whatever comes to the earth, whether it's the forehead or the chin or whatever happens in this pose for you. One more round of breath here. And walking the hands back towards your body. Rolling over the knees into a tabletop position. So we're going to bring the wrists underneath the shoulders, opening the fingers nice and wide like a starfish. And then once you do that, gripping the mat. So you're gripping through the fingertips, through that third knuckle, and into the palm of the hand. Taking the knees underneath the hips, slightly tucking the tailbone to protect the lower back. Staying here for just a moment in your tabletop, untucking your toes, keeping the knees about hips distance apart. Take a peek between the knees, if you can see your feet, taking them to the outside edge of your mat just a bit. In this tabletop position, we'll do 3 rounds of cat-cow. So inhaling, we're going to drop the belly, really exaggerating, pressing into the palms, lifting the gaze, and then exhale, rolling it all the way back. Inhale, open. And exhale, taking it back in. One more time, inhale to open. And exhale, cat pose. Coming to a nice neutral tabletop here. We're going to keep that left palm nice and planted. We're going to inhale, open the right side body, opening through that shoulder. And then as we exhale, we're going to scoop that arm underneath, palm facing up, and rest on this right shoulder. You can stay here, or you can add a little half twist to that as well. Nice inhalation, really opening that shoulder here, that twist. Right temple to the mat. One more round of breath. Releasing that left palm back underneath the shoulder if it's not already. Inhale, open up one more time. Exhale, right palm down to the earth. Taking a round of breath here in your tabletop position to reset if necessary. Keeping that right palm planted this time. Inhale, left up. Exhale, thread it through, left temple to the mat, left palm facing the sky, taking that half twist if you did on the other side. If you do, rolling that shoulder back, opening the heart space to the sky. One more round of breath here. Replacing that right palm underneath that right shoulder. Inhale, open one more time. Exhale, palm down. From here, bringing the knees a little bit wider, bringing the big toes together, sinking the sits bones back on the heels, and then extending into your child's pose. Taking a round of breath in your child's pose, feeling the yumminess of that, maybe moving around just a bit, and then tensing the fingers in your child's pose. And in inhalation, we're going to walk those fingertips all the way off the left side of your mat, keeping both sit bones down on the heels. Full inhalation. Exhalation. Your next inhalation is going to take you to your center over to the right side of your mat. And if you're not on the same side I am, it really doesn't matter as long as you do both sides. Breathing into that left side body, pressing into the fingertips, bringing the hips a little closer to the heels. Inhale, walk the fingers back to center. Pressing forward on the knees, bringing the knees in a bit closer, feet out, taking the hands a half a print ahead or so, tucking the toes, and we're going to lift the hips into your downward facing dog. Maybe your first downward facing dog of the day. Getting nice and settled here, keeping the fingertips nice and wide. Maybe widening your stance if that's more comfortable for you. There's no contest to see whose heels can reach the mat first, so just be where you are. Lifting through the hips, taking a moment to roll the shoulders back away from the ears. Inhale high up to your toes, and then exhale, melt the heels to the right side of your mat, equal pressure in both hands. Inhale, open.
Inhale to the toes. Exhale, heels to the left. Inhale to toes and exhale, melt those heels down. Taking a moment to pedal out the feet, putting a bend in one knee and then the other. Maybe hooking one of those ankles behind the other. Give a little extra stretch to one foot. Taking that equally on both sides. Inhale high to the toes. Exhale forward into a high plank pose. Inhale nice and strong here. Exhale knees, chest, and chin. Untuck the toes. Roll up to your cobra position. Tuck your toes. Downward facing dog. Inhale to the toes. And then with flat feet, walking those feet up to the top of your mat. Hello, hamstrings. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. Putting as much bend in your knees as you need to. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Plant the palms. Stepping back with the right foot and the left. Here you have some options. Either taking knees, chest, and chin to cobra again, or from that high plank, wrap those elbows in, lower down halfway chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Welcome those feet back to the top of your mat. Taking it nice and gentle here. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold and hold that forward fold. Maybe taking those palms to the back of your calves. One more round of breath here. Releasing those palms back to the earth. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant the palms. This time we're going to step back with the left foot, then the right. Taking your flow, knees, chest, chin, cobra. Or shift forward, lower down. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice full inhalation here. And a full exhalation. Taking the feet about mat distance apart or a little wider. Keeping that right palm where it is. Taking a nice side stretch here. Left palm to the right ankle. Inhale. Exhale. Placing the left hand, taking that nice side stretch to the opposite side. Inhale and exhale. Bringing those palms back in line with your shoulders. Bringing the feet back into your downward facing dog. Bringing the knees out nice and wide. Big toes together, sink back, child's pose. Maybe taking a little inventory of how you feel right now. Maybe taking a sip of water. We're staying in that child's pose, returning to your breath. One of my very special students gave me this water. So she may be out there. One more round of breath in your child's pose. Really sinking the hips down, extending through the arms, getting the most out of this child's pose again. Bringing yourself back up to a tabletop, taking the palms at hyperprint ahead, tuck those toes. Inhale, lift the hips, downward facing dog. Walking those feet forward once again. Those of you who step through, who jump through, can absolutely do that. I'm taking it a little easy today. From here, we're going to put a deep bend in our knees, bring our fingertips to the mat. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, sink a little deeper. Zipping up through the core, tucking the tailbone. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold, fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant the palms. Step back right foot and left foot. Taking your vinyasa of choice. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Taking a breath here. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, bring that foot through between the palms. Knee stays bent, knee over ankle. Turning the back foot to 45. Left hip in line with the right. Warrior one. Let round of breath here. Inhale. Exhale, maybe sink a little deeper. frame that foot. Step back with the right foot. Take your foot. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg rises. Exhale, bring that left foot through. Turn the back foot to 90, right hip in line with the left. Warrior one. Chair pose. You want your feet about hips distance apart. You want your chest lifted, your gaze is lifted, your core is engaged, your tailbone is tucked. So you're sitting right there on the edge of that chair, maybe even lifting up your toes, pressing those inner thighs together. Inhale, exhale, sink. Inhale, exhale, fold. In that forward fold, walking the feet out, wider than hips distance, grabbing opposite elbows, and just hang out here and sway. Allowing the head to just fall, let gravity handle that. Releasing tension in the lower back, in the hips. And then finding stillness here. Bringing those palms to your mat, walking those feet out slightly so that your toes are out, your heels are in. I'm going to put a deep bend in those knees and gently rise up into our goddess squat. Inhale here. Exhale, sink a little deeper. Tuck that tailbone, engage that core. Inhale, lift to five-point star. Exhale, squat. Inhale, lift. And last one, exhale. Inhale, lift. We're going to take those feet. We'll meet back at the top of the mat. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Plant the palms. We're going to leave that right foot where it is. Step back into that warrior one again with the left. Sweeping those arms up into warrior one. Sinking here. Nice and strong in your warrior one. Full round of breath. Inhale. And exhale, turn that back foot to 90. Warrior two. In your warrior two, your gaze is over that right middle finger. Take a peek if you can't see your big toe over that knee up just a bit. Inhale. Exhale, sink. Inhale, serve the body forward, flip that palm. Exhale, feet forward. And just tucking that left arm around it. And just come down the left leg. Stay here for a round of breath. Inhale. Inhale, straighten that right leg. Exhale, triangle pose. Maybe that right palm comes to the shin. Maybe it comes to the floor. Taking the gaze either to the foot or to that left hand. Inhale, open and lift. And exhale, shift that back foot so it's facing the top of your mat. Kick that foot forward a bit. Square the hips, left hip in line with the right. Inhale, half lift. And exhale, fold over that front leg into your intense stretch or your pyramid pose. Staying here for a round of breath. Nice full inhalation and letting go with the exhalation. Pivoting that back foot forward, kicking that foot up. Forward fold. Noticing the difference in your hamstrings right now. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Stepping back, top leg pose. Shifting forward, lower chaturanga halfway. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale to the toes, and this time tiptoe to the top of your mat. We're going to keep that left foot where it is. Supporting with your fingertips, stepping back, warrior one. Taking that left knee over that left foot. Inhale up. Taking inventory of those hips, they should be in line. Inhale, exhale, sink a bit. Inhale to prepare, turn that back foot to 90 degrees. Exhale, warrior two. Shifting however you need to, in my case, my clothes. Inhale, exhale, sink. Inhale, serve the body forward, flip that palm. Exhale, peaceful warrior. Maintaining the integrity of that left knee. Inhale. Hold it for the exhale. Inhale, straighten that left leg. Exhale, transition to your triangle pose. Stay here for a round of breath. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, lift. Frame that front foot. Pivot on that back foot. Bring it forward. Pyramid pose. Inhale, a half lift. Get nice and settled. Bring that right hip in line with the left. And exhale, fold. One more round of breath. Kicking that right foot forward to meet the left. Last vinyasa. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant the palms, step back, high plank pose. Make this one your best one. We'll meet in downward facing dog. Bring the knees mat's distance apart. Big toes together. Shifting back into your child's pose. Again, taking time for yourself. Perhaps remembering your intention at this time. Remembering that for just a moment. So staying in your child's pose. Coming out of your child's pose, lean the knees together. We're going to spin around and come to our bottom here. You're going to leave that right leg where it is. Bring that left foot nice and close. You could even take a half lotus if you like. Just whatever you don't press on your knee. We're gonna inhale, lift the arms, and exhale. Bringing that forehead to your feet, to your foot, Monday. Taking a nice full round of breath here. Feeling that extension all the way from the heel to the glute. Shoulders away from the ears. One more round of breath here. Bringing the palms to frame the foot and rolling up one vertebra at a time. Take it on the other side. Nice and grounded. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Taking those hands wherever they're comfortable. Maybe they reach the foot, maybe they reach the mat, maybe they reach the knee. No judgment. This is your practice. One more round of breath here. Releasing the hands, rolling it up, extending both legs. Getting nice and comfortable here. Big toes together, toes pointing towards your face. Inhale and try to keep the back straight as long as you can. Reaching over those feet. And then when it won't stay straight anymore, just let it go. One more round of breath. And releasing the palms and rolling it back up. Coming up to a nice seated position. Bringing the feet about hips distance apart. Extending the arms forward and sinking back into your boat pose. You'll know you're there when you begin to engage those upper abdominals. Y'all know if you've ever been to one of my classes, you're not going to get away without doing some core. You can
the shoulders back.
Exhale, hover in your canoe.
Inhale, boat.
Exhale, canoe.
Three more. Inhale.
Taking a nice full body stretch, lowering the arms by your side, bringing those feet straight up in the air, toes pointing toward your face, fingertips behind your ears. We're going to pulse it up for eight. So breathing at your breath, at your rate, 5, 6, 7, 8. No pressure on the head, left leg hovers, elbow to right knee. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Switch it. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Both legs lift. And those palms down in the lower. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, get control, 2, 1, let it go. Bring your knees into the chest. Give yourself a well-deserved hug. Gently rocking back and forth. Finding stillness and pull that left leg all the way through the mat. Lift fingertips to the outside of the right knee. Extend that right arm. Inhale, bring it close. Exhale, take that right knee to the left, the gaze to the right. 2 rounds of breath here. Inhale, exhale. One more full inhalation, full exhalation. Knees back into the chest, take it on the other side. Right leg extends, right fingertips outside of left knee, left arm extends. Knee to the right, gaze to the left. Two more rounds of breath. Nice and gentle. Coming back to center, giving yourself one more big hug. Really pulling those knees into the chest, making yourself as small as you can. Taking a full inhalation. And when you get to the top of that inhalation, sip in a little bit more. And when you can't take it anymore, extend, release, move into your Shavasana, your final resting pose, taking whatever pose is most comfortable for you. This is your time to relax. This is your moment. Integrating everything that we did, taking a moment to just remember your intention, and then letting that go too. Beginning to still your breath, beginning to slow down to your natural rhythm, and then letting everything go, all thoughts, and remaining in your Shavasana. To bring a bit of movement back into your body, once again wiggling fingers and toes, rolling wrists and ankles in one direction, the other, maybe turning your head gently from left to right, still supported by your mat. When you're ready, taking that full body stretch with your fingertips as far away from your toes as possible, taking that yummy good morning stretch. Bringing the knees into the chest, rolling over to your favorite.
favorite side into a fetal position, cradling your head with your bottom arm. Taking a moment to give yourself gratitude. And offer silent gratitude to anyone who may be practicing with you right now, whether in your house or whether in this great Facebook world. And I offer you my gratitude for allowing me to guide you in this practice. When you're ready, taking that top hand and pressing yourself up, finding a comfortable seated position, getting nice and grounded for a moment. Imagine there's a stream coming through the crown of your head, elongating your spine, tucking that tailbone slightly, protecting the back, being kind to yourself. I thank you so much for allowing me to come into your homes, into your yards, and guide you in this practice. I invite you to bring your palms to heart center. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. I wish you peace and joy in your mind.